Yes, hello. Hello, yes.
We're gonna go race town.
You do it. You do it. There we go. Everybody, there we go. Amen. I got you. I'm taking film. We're good. We're good. Mic check.
Make steel and bring it over here and sell it cheaper than we can make it.
Oh, that's jacked up.
And I lost my job in 82. I'm laid off for 2 years.
How old were you then?
I was 20 in 82. I remember some steel mill made this gigantic pipe about as big as round as this part of the bus and had a white coating on it. It was really pretty, and they brought it to Lone Star Steel, and all of us union people went and wrote our name on it, and there was a petition going to the White House. They parked it on the White House lawn.
Aww.
Asking Ronald Reagan to reinstate the tariffs on steel so that we could be competitive.
Because
we were no longer competitive.
Yeah, we weren't protected.
So basically, when I was 18, I started a job where I could actually see how the policies of the Republican president affected me and put me out of work. And that's why I saw it firsthand. And I saw globalization supposed to be the best thing. All globalization means is shipping our fucking jobs to Mexico, Japan.
Yeah.
That's all that means.
Creating another slave class. Like,
how old are you, Christy? Were you born in
85?
Oh, yeah. Born in the 80s?
77, I was born.
70. So.
You're a baby.
I remember in the 80s when everything was about downsizing and globalization and shipping our jobs.
That was the propaganda.
Everyone was buying into.
I remember globalization.
They were preparing people's minds.
But
like,
even then, I was smart enough to figure out they're sending our jobs off. Yeah.
Even then,
I'm drawing unemployment because you dropped the tariffs on steel. Oh, and in the car industry, I'm real in solidarity. Every time I buy a car, I go to the UAW's website and I print off a list of cars made in America made here by union workers, not made here by anybody, made by union workers. And I take that list to the dealerships with me, and I'll be damned if I buy a car that's not on that list. Everyone laughs at me.
You know what? It'd be really good if that's what everybody could do.
It would be good
would
if
be.
Everybody if everybody that bought a car this year would buy a car made by American union workers, it would create huge jobs.
Good deal.
That's all you have to do.
Thank you, Michelle.
It is recording.
Michelle, how are you?
It's recording. It's working.
Michelle.
It's very, very pink.
Already over here. You want to walk into City Hall Park first and see if there's a bathroom? Huh? All right, let's cross here while she welcomes.
What's your name?
Rudy.
Rudy's so awesome. He has his sign here. We just came off the train there. There's the train station on the 6th train, and we came to stop to use these fabulous public facilities. And Rudy, you're heading down to OWS, right?
Yes. I am told there's a demonstration. I was at Wall Street, but I was the only one there, so.
That is so awesome, Rudy. It's so good to meet you. And
Rudy Park is all fenced off by police.
Really?
Zuccotti.
They're such haters.
Well,
they don't want the people in power.
I don't blame
the patrol, right. Yeah.
And they come after your union, my union. They'll come after theirs before they come.
Well, we appreciate your shirt. We appreciate your sign. And you're so awesome.
Exactly. This is
City Hall.
Oh, here's City Hall.
And it was built, I believe, around 1812 or something.
Awesome.
Somewhere around
it burned down twice due to fireworks.
Did it really? I know
there
was a fire
on
the roof.
Two
times?
Twice.
Lincoln's body was brought there.
Yes.
And the only photograph of Abraham Lincoln dead was taken.
In state here?
Yeah.
Okay, for those that aren't here with us, we're walking just past the 6th Street train station in here in Manhattan. We just came off the train. And we're heading into... Is this the Cotty Park, James, or
no,
where does this?
This is Foley Square.
Foley Square, and we can see the crowds and hear the noise, and I'm wondering if you can hear it. We'll get more when we're closer. Here's some peace officers being peaceful. That's nice. That's good to see. And here we go. Here's the real deal right here. This is the warm-up for tomorrow. Imagine, he says.
We are dealing with agents of Puprod, United Puppets of Rich Assholes. Puprod, seizing and pillaging every office, big and small, in the land. This is what we are up against. So occupy, not a moment too late. Los Indignados in Spain, student strikes in Chile and Nation. What stops the Vietnam War? What got us civil rights and saved the earth?
Chrissy ran into Lee Camp. She's so excited.
He's a comedian, they said.
Okay, so now we're leaving the northern part of the square, I think. This is further down.
So, in the meantime, my band is going to stay there and I'm going to go back to work and I'm going to stay in the office.
The revolution will not be televised. So here's the Astoria people that James is with, Occupy Astoria, and they have a little information table here. You can sign up for more information. Good people.
I'm actually going to go to Starbucks.
That's pretty awesome. You guys, so we just ran into Adam, to David Verona. We're looking for Adam Peck. And this is his lawyer that got him out. And apparently this young woman was arrested with him as well. So we're finding what Occupy Dallas people we can find here. Okay, so we just found Beverly. And Beverly was just given a Metro card by a kind occupier. And where are you staying, Beverly?
At a warehouse.
At a warehouse with a bunch of other occupiers, which is awesome because she's seriously occupying. Like 100. That's awesome. That's awesome. And they said there's a lot more people on the way, like on buses and stuff.
Yeah.
So. How exciting. You look good though.
And when you hit that concrete ceiling, even after the record bill, you don't sink my bitch as long as you're playing for the other team. The hoodie living the American dream. The white never scared. Never scared. Prepared. Get prepared. Now be left stuck in this nightmare. Hey yo, news lies to ya. Schools don't sue ya. Cops wanna shoot. So what you gon' do about it? Rich get richer, poor get thinner. How comfortable your pillow? So what you gon' do about it? As long as you're playing for the other team. The hood ain't living the American dream. So I ain't never scared. Never scared. So we get prepared. Get prepared. Now we left stuck in this nightmare.
Movement and everyone's allowed to see. Also, we have a sense of humor too. The other thing is that right after the concert here, after the band plays, and the band is going to be in the crowd with you, not this band, but the next one, is going to be in the crowd with you. When they're done at about 6, we're going to do an action briefing for everybody so we all know what's going on. If you haven't gotten your maps yet, go get your maps at the info table, but everyone's going to be able to see what's going on. We're going to do a really brief training from 6 to 7:10 in this space, and then at 7:10, Occupy Faith.
We're walking into the financial district now. James has spoken to the police officers to find where the barricades are, and we're going to meet up with the general crowd. Okay, we just left an enclosed area stopping workers from going in. Several workers were not able to attend work today. And we also encourage people not to go to work. Take a day off in peace and justice and help the world be a better place. Some people did walk away, so there was some success in that area. And here's a second barricade area that people are hoping to be successful at. So we're still in the financial district, and we had an impromptu GA and decided to head to AIG, and this is the AIG building. And there's several of us in our group, in our cohort. There's several cohorts around the financial district now, and this one we decided to storm AIG. So that's where we're headed. These are all the people. I don't know quite what's going to go on, but we'll find out when we get in here. So we're in the building. We're having an impromptu decision here. We're going to occupy the space, I suppose. All in good spirits, all in good spirits.
Mic check!
Mic check!
Mic check!
Mic check!
Seems to be very agitated about taking pictures. And in truth,
while I enjoy being a member of the public,
able to come into this sterile and characterless space, able to come into this sterile and characterless space. I do feel that we would be more visible
outside.
And then AIG
can be reminded that we, the taxpayers,
own them.
Because they were among the worst financial managers in the history of mankind.
Because they were among the worst financial managers in mankind.
And we paid huge amounts of our taxpayer dollars to help them keep their jobs.
And we made huge amounts of taxpayer dollars to help them keep their jobs.
It never
made sense to me.
I think it's an opportunity to remind them
who their bosses are.
Mic check.
Mic check.
Let's go. Let's call the cops. Let's go.
Regroup in the front.
One. We are the people. Two. Vision is not leaving. One. We are the people. Two. We are united. Three. This occupation is not leaving. One. We are the people. Two. We are united. Three. This occupation is not leaving. One. We are the people. Two. We are united. Three. This occupation is not leaving. Oh, there we go. I didn't know two people couldn't do it. I apologize.
No,
and that it would be wrong.
Illegal.
And something that their commanders would not like.
For them to disrupt a picket line.
I propose
that we circle up.
Keep moving. Picket AIG. Remind them who owns their sorry asses.
And tell them to give back the money they stole.
Yeah!
Woo!
Yeah! All right. All right. Taken over the intersection with the dance party, Occupy dance party. Oh, it's gonna happen from here.
I said 25,000, sir. These are just people willing to get arrested.
Right.
Right. That's so true, right?
Exactly.
Let me get a shot of these people over here. Have a good day, guys. police officers down there. And we are being corralled this way. So they have a plan, and we also have a plan. But keep the peace. Thank you for keeping the peace. We appreciate you keeping the peace. Thank you for being lovely peace officers. These are NYPD peacekeeping officers. And we encourage them to keep the peace and encourage peaceful protesters.
So the people in the green hats are the lawyers. There's several of them. I've seen them running around, and they're protecting people, making sure people know their rights and are being protected. And I don't know what was going on. I guess they arrested some people and put them in paddy wagons, so everybody was kind of gathered over there. But we all seem to be heading back, and the crowd is definitely dispersed, and they're probably gathering up in some area, but we don't know where yet, so we're kind of standing around waiting to see. It's amazing. All of these buildings are just insane, and all of these people, you really don't know who's a protester or who's just on the street. There's some journalists talking about what happened.
They did? What did they
say?
Really? Thank you for keeping the peace. Peaceful police officers, thank you for being peaceful. Thank you for being peaceful. Here we are at Exchange Street and Broadway. And in this corridor here that you can see, that is Wall Street. And the police officers have blocked off all of Wall Street from the protesters. You can see how little activity there is down there, because people, including people that work down there, aren't being allowed down there without an ID. Several people were turned away earlier this morning. They won't let us on that side of the street either. So there's just a little picture of the police state, but you know, here you can see a blatant disregard for the people's freedom of speech and right to protest. Said bull, there are several police officers protecting the bull rather than protecting the people. You can see they go all the way down. So once we get these officers to realize they need to protect the people, I think we'll be good. Here we just passed the bull back there, and we walked all the way down Broadway, and this is all the financial district in actual Wall Street. And you can see how many police officers have gathered to protect the bankers. They're not protecting the people, but paying to protect the bankers. So it's just kind of a rapid show of who exactly owns this country.
A tree of Liam.
We're grateful to you.
plant your thousands of seeds.
Go out into the wind.
Wherever we are, that will be a seed. That will be a seed.
Long.
Protect the golden
calf!
It just never ends.
Preserve idolatry!
So many people out here, it's
hey,
almost...
Hey, Cupcakes, how are you?
Unable to...
Where are you from?
Over here in New York City.
Where are you from?
Angelo, they want to know where we're from, New York.
Okay, we're from Texas.
Texas, I'm from the country, lady. Look at me. Angelo, she's making me look good.
I do.